What's up?
He does.
Happy Saturday, September. I have no idea what day it is. September. Happy Saturday, September 5th. I'm Percy. This is Mercy. Mercy's behind the camera. Every day we upload a short little video that's hopefully interesting, educational, maybe a little distracting.
Motivational!
Motivational?
I don't know why I said that so excitingly, because I don't even know what that means. I don't think it means exciting, so...
It's kind of exciting. It gets people to go do stuff. That's what motivational means. They feel motivated to accomplish something. You know what we celebrate today on September 5th? International Day of Charity.
Huh?
Mother Teresa died on September 5th, 1997. Mother Teresa was a nun.
Was a nun?
Typically, this is all changing. I think who knows. But typically, a priest has been a man, a nun has been a woman. Who they're devoted to the church, to helping. So I was taught by some nuns, and they're teachers, they're people who help with church, they're people who help the poor, and they help do things like charitable causes. They're kind of employees of the church.
Nuns are most common in Buddhism, but have more recently become prevalent in other traditions.
Where?
Catholic, Eastern Orthodox, Anglican, and Lutheran.
There you are!
Mother Teresa was a nun, I think a Catholic nun, and from a very even young age, she was devoted to helping the poor, especially in India. She tried to do a lot of things for the poor, like open up clinics to help them, that help the sick and the poor. A lot of people regard her as someone who did a great deal, who devoted her life to helping other people and helping poor people. Today we celebrate someone like Mother Teresa, who's given a great deal to charity and to people who need our help. The story of the day is
about Mother Teresa.
No.
Every time that we say it's going to be about the theme, it's not about the theme or not about what we say it's going to be about.
You're trouble. It is about the theme. I still have a story of the day that's about the theme, but it's not even a story of the day. All I know is on a day like the day of charity, of giving, people look to things like charities. But what I didn't realize when I was younger, and probably still don't really, have still not really realized until recently, is there's a lot of bad charities out there. You don't want to just give your money to any charity, because a lot of charities are wasting your money. Really worth spending just a little bit of time researching what those charities are. And if something that you think is worthy is on the list of good charities or bad charities. So here's a Fast Company article on just five charities that sound really good and are really not good. For example, the Kids Wish Network.
What's that about?
Well, it sounds really good, doesn't it? The Kids Wish Network? It's a knockoff of the Make-A-Wish Foundation. Over the last decade, $3.2 million went to actually granting the wishes of sick children, while nearly $110 million went into corporate fundraisers. So instead of giving it to the children, they've spent it on parties. That's awful. Cancer Fund of America, something similar. Children's Wish Foundation. Didn't we just do Children's Wish Foundation? Oh, there's two. Great. There's Kids Wish Network and there's the Children's Wish Foundation.
What's that one about?
Similar kind of thing. It's supposed to be like Make-A-Wish, but instead they spend 10 times the money that they spend on the kids on the fundraisers. American Breast Cancer Foundation. Firefighters Charitable Foundation. Again, if you keep seeing this, 90% on its fundraisers, 10% on the victims.
Example of a good organization that you can run by?
What I can tell you is a couple things. One, if you want to do some research on charities that are doing really good, go check out, there's a couple indexes that are tracking this stuff
what
and doing
indexes?
Research. Well, they're basically like best of lists. They're like, hey, these charities, we've done the research, they look like they're doing really good stuff. They're managing their money well, they're helping a lot of people. So some organizations that you want to check out that are doing this kind of research is GiveWell, Charity Navigator and GuideStar. GuideStar, I think, gives them a platinum rating, if I understand this correctly, is charity water. They're trying to open up wells, like they're trying to create safe drinking water for places that are not drinking water safely, like the water's dirty and they don't have water. But I think charity water spends like 100% of the money raised by donors, and then they have like a separate fund that they specifically go after funds to raise money for, like, running the operation. So they try to, like, really separate what's being used to run the operation and what's given. So it's really easy to track, hey, this money, the money you give to charity water is going to go towards water for people.
Yeah. At least they used to do that. I don't know if they still do that.
I think they're still in good standing. I think charity water is attempting to do the right thing versus some of these 90% partiers. Hey, Merce.
Yes.
Why
do crabs never give to charities?
Yeah.
I don't know why.
Because they're shellfish.
Shellfish.
I think it's too early for this family. That joke was posted by Howie WU0402 on Reddit. Ending my day with a donation to charity water. That little donkey or burro, that guy's gotta get people to donate.